Do magnets affect plant growth? Can we use fresh cow dung or horse dung for plants? What happens when you expose roots to light? Can we grow plants from leaves? Do plants feel pain? Do plants die of old age? In today's episode, we'll quickly debunk 20 interesting and unbelievable gardening myths and reveal some extremely useful scientific facts and tips related to gardening. Please watch it till the end. Coming up. At number 20, fresh cow dung or horse dung is very good for plants. This is absolutely false. Fresh cow poop should never be applied for your plants because it not only stinks but contains high levels of ammonia and salts which can burn your plants. It also contains harmful microorganisms like E. coli, which are harmful to plants as well as humans. Plus, it also contains weed seeds, which can produce a lot of weeds or unwanted plants in your garden. So, always use decomposed cow dung or horse dung for your plants. You can watch a detailed video on 5 hacks to quickly decompose cow dung from a link in description below or from an end screen link at the end of this video. Let's move on. At number 19, is it dangerous to expose roots to light? Well, this can be a very nice high school project for kids to grow 2 similar plants, one in a transparent container and one in an opaque container, and then compare these two. As you can see, nothing happens to the plant grown in transparent container. The actual concern is root exposure to air and even the heat from sunlight that can cause drying and can damage your plant. But still, you're advised to keep the roots in the dark. This is because of algae growth due to light, and your roots are not getting enough oxygen because the algae is stealing the oxygen and nutrients for itself. So, light as such does not hurt the roots, but air, heat, and algae hurt the roots and can kill the plant. At number 18, do plants feel pain? There are many studies and researches conducted on this topic. Basically, plants lack a nervous system, that is a brain, and other neurological structures like nerves and pain receptors. So they should not feel pain, unlike in humans and animals where we have specialized pain receptors. But according to some researchers, plants can know of themselves being eaten because studies have shown that plants release defense chemicals in response to caterpillars munching on them. Other points include plants fighting for territory, seek out food, evade predators, and interestingly trap prey like what you see in carnivorous plants like the Venus flytrap. They are as alive like any animal, and like animals, they exhibit behavior. At number 17, talking to your plants will help them grow. People who really love plants and gardening will often tell you that talking to plants or even music has a beneficial impact on overall health and growth of the plants. Despite many different scientific studies on this theory, there is still no conclusive evidence that talking to plants can help them grow. One theory says that since plants take up carbon dioxide, and hence talking to plants releases carbon dioxide when we exhale. So that explains it all. At number 16, plants can die of old age or aging. The oldest known tree in the world is the Great Basin Bristlecone Pine in the White Mountains of California, which is over 5,000 years old. Actually, trees grow indeterminately, meaning that with the right conditions, they can grow and grow and grow. But the only problem that limits them from reaching up to the sky is the food and water transport through xylem and phloem to the growing ends from the roots. The taller the tree, the more difficult it is to transport water from the roots to the foliage near the top. But here what happens is, instead of growing taller, they increase in width and also branch out more, as you might have noticed some old trees with huge girth of the stems. At number 15, animal or human urine can be used as a fertilizer. Yes, this is a fact. For example, cow urine contains loads of NPK, that's nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, which are the most essential plant nutrients for agricultural use. But it has to be applied in dilution of at least 1:20 in water. At number 14, is it dangerous to go near trees during nighttime? Well, in daytime, under the presence of sunlight, that's photosynthesis, plants take up carbon dioxide and release oxygen. But during night, they take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide. And hence, the air near trees will have lesser concentration of oxygen and higher concentration of carbon dioxide. But this impact will be negligible for small plants and at home gardens. and only be noticeable near very large trees or in thick vegetation. At number 13, naphthalene balls or moth balls contain naphthalene acetic acid and can be used as a rooting agent. It's a myth. NAA, that is naphthalene acetic acid, and IBA, indole butyric acid, are plant auxins or hormones which are entirely different compounds and used for rooting your plant cuttings. These two are entirely different from moth balls, which are used to keep insects at bay. At number 12, watering plants on a hot sunny day will magnify the sunlight through the droplets acting as convex lenses and burn the leaves badly. No doubt, watering plants early in the morning or late in the evening is great because less water is evaporating during the daytime. But this theory that water droplets on leaves can act like mini magnifying lenses, focusing the sun's rays and causing leaf burn, has been completely disproved by physicists. At number 11, planting by the moon affects plant growth and yield. The idea that the moon affects plant growth is an old one that is believed by many people. This is a myth. No study has proven the effect of moon on plant growth. And the only plants that use moonlight for photosynthesis are certain types of phytoplanktons which are not normally found in gardens. At number 10, crushed eggshells are a good source of calcium to treat calcium deficiency. This is false. Even powdered eggshells take a long time to decompose and release that calcium into the soil and make them available for uptake by plants. You can make a water-soluble free calcium using eggshells by mixing it with distilled vinegar to make this happen. You can find this detailed video from a link in description or from a link in the top right corner of the screen. At number 9, saplings or seedlings need to be supported to protect them. True or false? This is false. Many people recommend you to provide support to these young, slender plants due to the risk of wind blowing them and things like that. Unless it's a strong wind, tying a sapling or young plant to a support stick or any kind of support will actually do more harm than good. Research has shown that the trees without support over a period of time will develop thicker trunks, more supportive roots, and more resistance to breakages. At number 8, do magnets affect plant growth? This is a fact. Magnetism affects plant growth and seed germination positively. Studies have shown that when plants are exposed to a magnetic field with south pole facing towards the roots, seeds germinate faster and plants grow faster and stronger in the presence of magnetic field in the soil. You can check a detailed video on this experiment from a link in description below or from a link at top right corner of this video. At number 7, can harvested or collected seeds be stored in a refrigerator or freezer? This is not true. Most seeds that are stored in seed banks are first dried up so that the moisture content is reduced to about 10%, and then these can be stored for several years. But if you freeze freshly collected seeds, the moisture content in these seeds will form ice crystals within and can destroy the seed viability. At number 6, growing fruit trees in containers is not possible due to limited space. This is not true. You can grow them, but you need little larger containers or fabric bags like more than 18 or 24 inches. You can watch a detailed episode on the top 10 terrace gardening myths and facts from a link in description below. At number 5, does potting mix cause legionnaires pneumonia in gardeners? Do not worry. This is not true. Legionnaires pneumonia is a severe form of pneumonia or lung infection mostly caused by inhaling the bacteria. Though these Legionella bacteria survive in outdoor soil, it rarely causes infections. But still, prevention is better than cure. Better wear a mask while handling a dusty potting mix, especially people with weaker immune systems. At number 4, how do I know my plant is still alive and how to save a dying plant? There are many signs to know whether your plant can still survive. If your plant is looking dry and has shed its leaves, most of us think it's dead. But actually, it may be alive or can be revived. Please watch my detailed episode on this topic demonstrating how to save a dying plant. You can check that link from description below. At number 3, can we grow plants from leaves? Yes, some but not all plants can be propagated from just a leaf or a section of a leaf. Leaf cuttings of most plants will not generate a new plant. They usually produce only a few roots or just decay. There are many ways you can grow leaves into a plant, like from a leaf petiole, by dividing a leaf into multiple pieces, for example, fleshy succulents like sansevieria or the snake plant and other succulents. Other methods of propagation like cane or stub cuttings, root cuttings, leaf bud cuttings, and so on. At number 2, gardening on terrace is bad for the building. This is not completely true unless your building is too old with a poor construction. Otherwise, if wisely planned, a garden on terrace will not be a problem, like placing the heavy containers along the walls of your terrace, which are weight-bearing, or main walls of the building, and things like that. Waterproofing the terrace is not always necessary unless you plan to build raised bed terrace garden. If you grow in containers, you only need to check whether the water draining out of the pots is easily flowing out of the terrace and not stagnant. At number one, does electric current affect plant growth? Well, there is a separate science called electroculture farming which utilizes this effect. I've conducted a simple experiment on this topic to study the effect of electric current on plant growth. You can watch that episode from an end screen link or from Garden Tips channel. Please like, share, and comment below with your queries and feedback. Happy gardening!